What's up? Welcome, everybody. Today I'm working on this wall boss fight, back from GDC. Starting to finally get a little bit of rest, feeling normal. So what I'm doing to this wall boss, he was always kind of, it's kind of a boring fight because all you really did was, you had to stay in this middle zone here, and if you get off to the edges, he closes his eyes and he gets all shielded up, and so this is the part that's not fun. When he just stays here with his eyes closed, it's like nothing's right. So I got two more attacks I'm gonna work on, and they'll be combined, and they can be used when his eyes are closed. So this will be like one of these is a scan attack. Let's see if he does it. Need more health. Yeah, I gotta get set up for this fight. Oh, there we go. Got the chat window open. I'm not gonna use Photoshop. All right, we want health. Need some life containers. Well, I definitely need some life containers to fight this guy. It's two feet more. Nah, just that one. There we go. Okay. Boop, 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 boop. Okay, first thing I need to make it so he can do his attacks. What's up, professional novice? Howdy, man, what you doing today? Okay, so his attack mode, wait, where does he get into his, shield up mode. Oh, shield up mode is mode one. Shield down. Okay, so attack can happen if it's mode 1 or mode 0. Yeah. Oh, sweet. Now we got an attack. Oh, he opened up his eyes, though. Okay, man. That already made this whole fight a lot more interesting. Just making it so he can open up his eye. Even if you're on the right side. Okay. The next thing I want to do is he's got these little, he drops these bombs. He does his little scan thing and then drops bombs on you. But I want all these bombs to be pretty close to you. What's up, voice of Grog? Howdy. How you doing today? Thanks, dieharders. So I'm thinking like a different format here. Yeah, let's call this Target Rand. So it knows. Oops. Nice. Yeah, all is very well. It's been a really exciting week. I was at GDC this week and got to demo the game at this press event called The Mix. And I got a demo at another event called ID at Xbox event called The Loft. And man, it was a really great week. Got to meet a lot of people. I got to like go and explore the expo finally this time. So I was like, finally got to know, you know, what happens at GDC. Yeah. Oh, tons of great input. Totally. It was really fun to just fun to connect with a lot of people again in person. You know, see how people's years were going and stuff. Yeah, tons of great feedback. Lots of people played the game. I was part of this this live stream with Danny O'Dwyer on Monday night, and the crew from Area 5. They're all just, I was like really humbled to be part of all this stuff. Like such a great opportunity to promote Songbringer, just to be with like, just like to be at those events, you know. I was like humbled to actually be accepted to those. It was really great. Okay, so we're going to use a new position called Target Rand. Yeah, there is. Let me get the link. Oh, here it is. Hi. Ah, there it is. All right, so when it does a spawn, behavior spawn. It can choose a rand. Yeah, here's where it's like. Ah, okay. So we'll use this parse position function. Yeah, man. That was fun. That was a fun event to be at. A really fun live stream to be on. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention I was dressed as a wizard. Yeah. It was fun. Okay, so I need a way to parse this target rand. But area parse position already does this. Okay, I think I'll do it to here. So if it contains this target rand, this is a tricky one. How do I do this? Maybe I'll look at all the other places that are already doing parse position. There's only one place that uses it? All right, cool. Let's just change it. Parse position, let's make it so it takes the position. Cool, so I'm making it so this function can take a vector of three floats. And that way I can seed it with a certain value. So if the word is, now I have like, if the word is, instead of it being rand, if it's target rand, it just has to pre-populate the pause with the target's position and then add a little bit randomly. Yeah, there we go. So now it's passing in the position that it starts with, and it already starts with, oh wait, it doesn't start with the target position, it starts with the entity's position. That's not actually what we want. Okay, so we do need that thing I just deleted here, but it's a little simpler. It's just pause equals the target's position. What's up, Pro Tito? Thank you. Yeah, they're not released yet, but they're coming this summer. Yeah, I'm really excited. Really, really excited to have it on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One this summer. Man, so cool, right? Isn't that sweet? Songbringer coming on all these platforms. I'm really thankful to Double 11 for making all this happen. Okay, so pause is the target's position. There we go. So if we spawn and it has the word target rand, then it gets the position of the target before it parses the position. And then the parse position needs to be a little smarter and know how to take a target rand. So this is pause.x plus equals drandf01. No, just drandf times 50, maybe 20, about a blocks. Yeah, I guess block size would be good to you. We're in area, so we could just do randomly up to a oh yeah, I guess the radius does matter a little bit, huh? Target rand, how much rand? I'm thinking like up to 2.5 to 3 blocks. Let's start with 3. There. Okay, so now parse position is a little smarter. Let's make sure this all works as intended. What should happen is when the wall bus does this little scan thing and the bombs fall, the bombs should all fall near the player, the hero. The hero's position. Ah, we're good. Okay, so the only problem was that the X was really good because it did plus or minus going the other way, but the Y. Oh wait, no, the Y is plus or minus. Let's see it again. Maybe they just all fell to the north of the hero. By chance? Probably not. Oh yeah, that one fell below. Oh, both those did. Alright. So what if I... Okay, scan me over here. Oh! The bombs all fall where he scans you, though. So if you move away... Okay. That's pretty cool. I'm liking this. Liking this, man. Maybe a little tighter. No. It was kind of better with it a little more random, because if you move, it can kind of reach out maybe. Okay, so I want to change these to be fear bombs now. Bomb foe? How does it do that? Maybe the bomb foe could be smart enough. Wait. Let's check this in. Okay, this is wall boss, scanner beam, and bombs. Okay, wait, if this just had the fear flag, I wonder if it would be a fear bomb or not. Okay, the only thing I want to change there is the smoke. think that's mood explode. Yeah, so there's a smoke that it drops here. Oh, you can't pass a color to smoke? All right, so we'll do it this way. If the color was already white, so we start with white. If this is a fear bomb, where do we get that? Is there some color here somewhere? So let's say if we have K filter fear in the collision, then the color becomes the color of fear. Or could just do this ahead of time. Ahoy! What's up, Salad Dongs? How has things been going, man? Yeah, it's going wrong. It's going great. Yeah, totally, man. I'm having a nice, relaxed Saturday. What you been doing this week, man? All right, let's see if those bombs are now fear bombs. So how's your week been, man? Right, let's set a breakpoint. Oh, that's not faux. Oh, whoops. Never mind. I already know it's wrong. Oh, that's from Fine Crafted Bomb. Oh yeah, lots to do for class. Oh, that's right. You've been in like the where's was it midterms or was it like actual end of term stuff? Yeah. Anyways, I remember you're in a point where it's like a lot of work right now. Okay, let's delete that. Well, actually, that might make the color really cool for the player's bombs. Oh, nice. Right on. Mostly done. Cool. Really? How have you been liking it? Modeling in Blender and stuff. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is make it so the bombs that are foes on the for the fear always have they're always fear bombs, basically. So we don't have the current area yet. Really? Oh, that's good. I guess it doesn't even need the area for most of this stuff. Okay, so the style character for the fear dungeon, I think it's 7. Oh, it's 9. Style character 9. Okay, so any bomb, any foe bomb in the fear dungeon will always be the fear bomb. I'm trying to make the boss fight a lot more interesting. Right now, what the biggest problem is, if you were before I started the stream, the biggest problem was if you stood to the side, he would close his eyes and he would just was kind of boring. You know, nothing's really going on. And he only had this one, like, weak-ass attack where he would create a fear cloud thing, which wasn't very clear what was going on. So, all in all, there's a lot more exciting things I can do to make the fear boss a lot more exciting. Exciting things I could do to make it more exciting. But what I mean by that is I want him to push you into the next room, for example, too. So there's two things on my list. Is one, to give him more attacks, and 2, to push him into the next room. Push you into the next room as the hero. Ah, he's not doing his other attack. Come on, do it. Do it. There. Scans. Drop some bombs. Let's see if these bombs all have black clouds now. No, they weren't black. Ay, ay, ay. Yeah, it'll, it is currently insta-death, and it will be insta-death on the next screen, too. So he's just going to push you back a whole screen. So, like, you'll fight him for one entire screen. There's no way you can beat him on the first screen. He pushes you into the next screen, and that's where there's spikes on the back, so it's like clear that you're gonna die if he pushes you all that way. And so that's just how it goes. You fight him on 2 screens. Yeah. It should definitely make him more interesting, and it also make him kind of unique. He'll be the only boss fight which takes place on 2 screens. Yeah, and you'll have to walk through that room with the spikes first, so it'll build up the tension. You'll see the spikes there already. You have to walk through that entire room to get to where the boss fight starts in the next room. So you're already kind of like, it should be building up some tension. Okay, let's just set a breakpoint there. Speed up time until he does the attack. Oh, there we go. We didn't get the breakpoint though. What? Oh, it still ran in. Oh, okay. I gotta fix my script. What happened? Oh. This is supposed to be X code, not just X. Okay. Reload. Now, if I'm in Xcode and I run, oh right, yeah, cool. It saved. It saved iTerm, but then it ran in Xcode. Actually, it doesn't need to. Really doesn't need to save Vim if it's not open. Okay, so if I run from Vim, it smartly runs in Xcode while saving. Okay, and if I go back to Xcode and run, it just runs. Cool. Oh. Oh, I know, right? This Lua code? I've had to learn Lua because of Hammerspoon. I've been forced to learn Lua. I kind of got the basics of it now, so I'm like not having to look things up all the time. Lua's weird. Okay, but done there. No more Lua. Okay, so I can run from here and run it until a bomb drops. So we can see why that these bombs are not black, like colored yet. Oh, you know, did I set the color for the freaking smoke right? Oh, I know what it is. Oh, in Elisp, yeah. How you been going with that? There. Okay, so now it's only going to modify the color if it's white. Yeah, with Elisp. 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 Oh, yeah? That's kind of how I am with Lua. Yeah? Yeah. Same here. That's a good idea. Okay, so now it's not clamping the color. It might have just improved it. Might work now. Yeah, good. The fear is definitely a different color this time. Yeah. Dang, getting messed up. Yeah, there's a few things that make me go, huh, too. You can't return. That's one thing. You can't just return from a method. You have to, if you want to, I mean, if you want to just return from a method at any point in the method, you have to, like, enclose it in some weird if statement. Like, if true, return, end. Oh, yeah. Use void pointer all the time. You can, I mean, there is a return, but they make you encapsulate it in this weird, like, whole another block if you want to just return from the method in the middle of it. Yeah, you can only naturally return at the end of the method. It's like they enforce all these, like, ideals. They enforce these crazy ideals that just, like, it's like, okay, I have to think. My brain has to think that way, I guess. I'm forced to think in the Lua way. Yeah, exactly. Makes for better debugging. Right. And that's why they do it, you know? It's like an ideal thing. They're like, oh, we're going to make everybody better debuggers by doing this. But if you're not used to all doing everything that way, or if you have good reasons for returning, like, for example, I don't like to use return statements in the middle of methods either, but what I'll frequently do is, like, if I want to just, like, you know, quickly disable an entire function, I'll do this. I'll do return just to see, so I don't have to, like, go and, you know, change the whole method or whatever, or like comment everything out, so, which takes forever. I just do a return statement, and you just can't do that in Lua without wrapping the return statement in some other stuff. That's all I really use it for, is just this. Okay, smokes have colors. These bombs falling make this boss fight already more interesting. That's cool. Oh, wait, we should take away that bomb flow having fear. That's not right. Oh, as an added bonus, if the player has crafted bombs, it should be colored now. Yeah, what's that? Like, we'll do, is it, I think it's just fear bomb. Or poison bomb or whatever. HD, what's up? Keyword you'd put before a function declaration that would toggle whether function contents are executed. Oh, that's awesome. That's so great. You should put a single word before the function that just basically disables everything in the function. That'd be so great. Yeah, dummy. Yeah, that'd be so great. So if I drop a fear bomb, what color will it be? Oh, is there no, there's no, come on. Yeah, man, it was great. Thanks for stopping by to say hey, man. Oh, now the color's completely gone. Oh, that would be so cool, Salad. I would love to see this. Okay, so I must have broke the smoke. The smoke is broke. I must unbroke the smoke. Does this even work? It's equals colors. I think it does. Colors can, they wrote that. Okay, if this is commented out, does it work? Yeah, totally right. That's so cool. The LLVM can do that. What happened to the smoke? Oh, is there no smoke in the on the overworld? You're on Skype? Or you were on Skype earlier, and now you're not? Oh. Yeah, this is the new smoke, and the animation's new and stuff. Whoa. Double typing. Okay, so it's not this statement there. Why isn't there any smoke on the overworld? You know what? This doesn't matter. I could fix that later. You can start here and then give the player, say, the poison bomb. And it should be green. That's all I really need to check. Thanks, man. What happened? What the hell? Oh, there it goes. There it goes. It's going. Yeah, you did. You did tell me. Good job, man. Yeah, okay, that's all I wanted to see. We got some green smoke. I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to be able to be hurt by your own elements. So yeah, that's fine. Good, good. I just want to make sure that still worked. Or like it would be colored. Okay, so back to the boss. And we took away that bomb foe flat, or that fear flag from the bomb foe. So, I need to verify that the new bombs here work. Oh, no. I don't think they did. Oh. I know why. It's here, it needs to, when it's checking if it's a foe, it needs to It's like it's adding a. Okay, this is add fear. So the bomb e.collision.category is K filter fear. There. Time I had fear. What's up, Wolski? How you been, man? Thanks, man. What you been doing? How's everything? Yes. Awesome. Using Unreal? Awesome, man. Sweet. What kind of game are you gonna make? Blood Gun is Maximus. It's going really well, man. How are you doing? Oh, survival action RPG. Sweet. Gotta keep it simple. All right. Cool, dude. Have you drawn any mock-ups or anything yet? Oh, sweet. You're thinking about the main character and the setting? Awesome. Ooh, dude, I'm excited. Okay, so he drops bombs now, and that should make it more interesting. Let's actually try this out. I'm gonna play this boss. See how this goes. You have a sketch? Cool, nice. That's good to hear. You've been sketching some characters. So if I go off to this side, I can't hit him. Oh, he's still... Oh, because he went into mode 2 or whatever. Okay, so when he goes back, when he drops bombs, he needs to go back into mode. If he has a shield, he needs to go into mode 1. Cool. This looks really good, dude. Trying out some different head styles, weapons. Looking good. How far done? It's getting there, man. It's coming out this summer. Spud Guinness, this is my own format. It's called Valtry. Whoops, sorry about the Google URL. Mechanical arms? Yeah. Sweet, man. I know, right? I just Google URL'd you. Blah. Okay, so I started to play the boss there, and there was one little problem because his shield stayed up. Actually, one quick way to fix this would just mean to be make it so when he's done with his bomb thing, he always has shield zero. Let's try that. Yeah, sorry, spam linked you. Just took up half the chat there. Okay, so I gotta work on that scanner beam so it comes from one of the like the left eye or something. Okay, so now he's got his shield up. He's gonna drop the bombs. Cool, and I can hit him again. I don't think I have the glove. It's gonna make this incredibly hard. And something keeps staying alive. What is going on over there? Oh, it might be that it's using those lamps that can be destroyed. I need the glove for sure to fight this guy. That's the gate item anyways. And let's try area patterns. Pattern boss. Just pattern boss, I guess. Where's the pattern? Where's the fear boss pattern? There's lightning boss. Here we go. Boss 9. That's right. Okay. So where are these blocks for the light pillars? Let's make these light sconces. And close Xcode. I don't need this. That definitely makes it a little harder to fight this guy with these bombs going off right near you. Oh yeah. So with him being like able to push you back. Oh, I forgot these little wormy guys. They can fly over the sky. I don't want them to be able to fly over the sky. Or they at least like should disappear in the sky. How would I do that? Just floating over the sky. Am I gonna be able to beat the game with my eyes closed? Of course. Yes. Yes, really. Really, really. Double really. All right. So that was a lot better. I lost a lot more health because of those bombs going off. And they did distract me a lot. Oh, it's random. It's random. There's a lot of different quotes already in there. That's just one of them. One of them is in your face. That's a good idea. I should find some good quotes from Kung Fu movies, huh? If you want like quotable Kung Fu movies though, you probably want to go back to like the 70s. Look at the awesome Kung Fu movies from then. Boards don't hit back. Check us out. Songbringer controller. I got this like Songbringer like sticker. This is thanks to Microsoft. They did this for me at the Xbox event. It's cool. Gave all the developers there some stickers for their games. That's a nice touch, isn't it? What? Okay, so what's next? The scanner beam thing would be nice to put it. Living the dream! Living the dream, you got your own sticker! I think they just sell those kind of stickers though, right? You can just buy those. You just make your own image and then, you know, print out a sticker for a controller. One day, Shifu! I shall have my own sticker! Heck yeah. One day it can come real soon. Okay, I've been debating, like, should I change? Yeah, I think so. The timer should be a little shorter after he attacks. And the fear gas seems like it needs to start a little higher. And I would like to see some lasers and, oh, and the scanner. The scanner should be to the left. Why isn't it on the left? Children, scanner beam, position negative 63, but it's not. In fact, it's even... What if I just don't even have a position there? Wait, what? There we go. Xcode was still open. Yeah, the scanner beam doesn't work. Nor does this position thing. Okay, the scanner beam, that could be figured out. It should be AI system. And it's where he does animate, scan, behavior. Wait, actually, we can just search for scan. We'll set a breakpoint here to make sure that's actually working. Wait, it has to be working. It has to find those to be able to do the scan. Oh, it doesn't have an offset. Does it? Thanks, Metrius. We're a guy put in a prison planet, the whole planet, and you have to survive. Oh, that sounds great, dude. Dude, this is like a great idea. This could be a great game. I like it. Let's just see what values we get. Oh, I gotta open Xcode again. Right when I close Xcode, I need to open it again. Yeah, that's sweet. Yeah, I got that. I got that concept. It's cool. Okay, so my next step I'm doing here is I'm making it so the scanner beam thing comes from the left side of the wall, and it should be on top of the wall as well. So oh yeah, just run with it, man. What makes you the most excited? Does that world make you the most excited? The most exciting thing to make? The prison planet? It's this cool idea, dude. You can run with it. You can run with anything, man. Any idea can become a great idea with some refinement. No, this is just this is like the one of the last bosses, but not the final boss. Sourced 1249, and it's the scanner. Destination is rock. Okay, so that's okay. Hopefully that is the actual, that's got to be the scanner entity. Okay, so it creates a scan beam entity. We got source. Source's name. We don't have any of this stuff, but I'm pretty sure that's... Oh, right. Yes, there you go. So what kind of villain could you put in there? Or antagonist. Okay, source position. course, it's like at that. Oh, that sounds cool. I haven't heard of Frieza. Who's Frieza? Oh, from Dragon Ball? I've only seen like the first episode. It was Dragon Ball. I gotta watch that. Yeah, I gotta watch this, man. There's so much like so much important information in this show that I've never, that I don't even have any clue about. Dragon Ball Z. I know, right? I gotta get with the program. Jeez. Okay, this is working. It's doing a scanner beam. It's just that it. The scanner beam is at the wrong position. And I think it's because it's the child of a moving entity. Yeah. Like, what can I do to. Where can I watch Dragon Ball? Awesome, I got it. I got it. I got the link. Think it's using a position chain. Yeah, who doesn't? Yeah, so it does chain from the parent to the child. And then so when the parent moves, it doesn't, I think the, yeah, we need to look up position component. Okay. The position chain, I never really use this distance and springiness. I would like to do that at some point. But the first thing I need to do is give it a V3F offset. No, they're hilarious. What? Oh, it's still being aired? Like there's new ones being written? Wow. I really gotta check it out. Okay, now that every position component has an offset, when it creates now, so now when we create each entity and we chain it to a parent, we need to set the child entities. Okay, wait, it already created the child entity, so it needs to take the child entities. Okay, so the child entity's position. Ah. Goku, is it a Vegeta or Vegeta? Goku Vegeta? Okay, let's see if that actually worked. Zilten, what's up, man? Oh, Vegeta. Vegeta. Makes me think of Velveeta. Nothing much. Welcome to the stream, man. Velveeta. I don't know if I'd want some of Goku's Velveeta, though. All right, man. Okay. This should be. Thanks for saying hi. See you, man. Yeah, get some rest. Okay. What entity is this? Oh, this is the lamp. Child paws is 90, 156. Oh, I didn't want I wanted the offset. Oh, it's child. Child is the entity. It's being created. Okay, this is the circle thing. Okay, so this offset's gonna be totally wrong. Because it's going to be the child's position. That's wrong. So what does it need to be? It needs to be the entity. Where does it create the position component? Oh, it does this set any pause, does it? Oh, it's just the child's position minus pause, whatever the hell that was. Okay, let's see that again. Okay. Position, chain right. What's he got this time? Chain right's offset 0. Nice. That's because it took the child pause and subtracted out the pause. Which child pause was will just give you the offset. Yeah, so the child pause was 9156. And the pause was 9156. Cool. That works. Okay, so now we have an offset. We can use chain left and chain right. And add these offsets in. It's going to be probably in move system. Move chain, there it is. It's probably this. Yeah, move chain. Move system, move chain. Nice. Yeah, man. Thank you. Good night, HD. Have a good one. Thanks for stopping by, man. Plus parent pause dot offset. Oh, parent pause. Oh, no, that's not right. We need the chain. Oh, wait. E position. Oh, damn. We need to. Yeah, that's right. Parent pause dot offset. Oh, dot chain left dot offset or chain right dot offset. Okay, so I guess this needs to be passed an offset to begin with. Wow, this is called from a lot of places. Okay, so this move chain method. Pass in a chain or move chain id, parent id. One sec. So I'm either gonna pass in a position component chain into the move system or an offset. Let's just pass an offset. It'd be simpler that way. When we're first moving, we pass in v3 of 0. And then later, once we're moving the chain, man, cross your fingers and see if all this works. Should be setting an offset and using the offset completely now. Oh. I don't know. I don't know if it worked. I don't think it did. Oh, I should verify that it's even doing it. Oh, apparently a NIMS is using that spring and dist. Okay, let's see this in action. We should be hitting both these breakpoints at the very beginning. Okay, cool. We're getting it hits for something. What is this? What entity? Lamp. Okay. This thing does have an offset. Let's see if it works for, okay, that worked for the lamp. The door. Oh. Okay, here's where we're creating the wall boss, which is good. So what's the wall boss's offset? Chain right, negative 63, 39. Id 1249. Parent. Baron 1248. Oh, I wonder if it's accidentally overriding. Like if it's double offsetting. No, it's still there. Well, let's see if the friggin' chain even works, like, for, was it a lamp? Not the lamp? Oh, here is the particles. The particles are at 0.16. What if we wanted to move the circle up as well? Oh, you can't have position with particles, that's right. Or with the flicker. Well, I don't know what to do about this right now. I was trying to work on this for the last like part of the stream here to get it so the scanner beam that scans you and then drops bombs on you. Oh no, what did I do wrong? Oh, that. I'm trying to get it so the scanner beam would be on the left of the wall, always on the left of the wall. So like one of the eyes would open or whatever and have a special attack where it scans you and then drops bombs on you. But I can't seem to get this red dot here, this position to move. There's something wrong with the math or something. Or the layers of chains of position components and stuff like that. So I'll need to take a little break here and think about how to do this. But once I'm finished, my plan here is to do another kind of attack. So there'll be like a giant, I'm thinking like a giant laser beam or something like that that shoots out of one of the right eye or something like that. So he'll have three different unique attacks and it'll all kind of like Should make him a lot more exciting to fight. And then the next step will be to have him push you back into the next room. That'll be pretty exciting too. So that's it for today's stream. Thanks a lot for watching. Yeah, there's something in there. Just a complicated amount of indirection. So, yeah. Appreciate everybody. Hope you all have a great night, and we'll catch you next time.